Hello friends, we are learning carbohydrates and in this particular video we will discuss about polysaccharides. So what are polysaccharides? The polysaccharides, the term as the term suggests, polysaccharides, which means they are the polymers of the small sugar units like glucose or galactose, or we can say any monosaccharide molecule. These polysaccharides are the polymer, the chains of that monosaccharide or that single sugar unit. So suppose there are so many sugar units are joined together, up to thousands or hundred to thousand molecules of sugar units joined to form a polysaccharide. So these polysaccharides can be grouped into by their functions can be grouped into the two types, like structural polysaccharides and the we can say storage polysaccharides. So first one is structural polysaccharide, and second one is storage polysaccharide. So we can classify polysaccharide into according to their functions, which function they are doing inside the cells. We can classify them in these two types, like structural polysaccharide and storage polysaccharide. So structural polysaccharides perform the function of helping the cells or into the stability of the cells or the organs. These structural polysaccharides helps to for the stability of the cells. They form the structures of cells, like a cell wall, or we can say plasma membrane or the cell membrane. So these structural polysaccharides are involved in those compositions of that structures of cells, which gives the cells stability, right? So these structural polysaccharides. After that, the storage polysaccharides are the store form of the energy. They stores the energy, or we can say they stores the small sugar units, and they are formed when we are consuming a lot of sugars. So they those sugar can be stored in the form of the structural polysaccharide. And one of the best example of storage polysaccharide is glycogen. Whenever we need energy, so cells take these storage polysaccharide gives the monosaccharide unit to the cells, and those monosaccharides will be depleted down, and that energy will be taken from that glucose molecules or whatever monosaccharide is. So storage polysaccharides. After that, these polysaccharides are also can be grouped into their structure according to their structure, like homopolysaccharide and heteropolysaccharide. Homopolysaccharide and heteropolysaccharide. Homo and heteropolysaccharide. Homo means the polysaccharide made up of only single type of a unit, only single type of monomeric unit, one unit. Like all the monomeric units, all the monomeric units involved in the structure of polysaccharide, it will be only one type of molecule, like D-glucose. So if we take the example of starch, so starch is the homopolysaccharide made up of only single type of this monomeric unit, like D-glucose. So all the monomers will be of D-glucose. Another molecule will be not involved in the starch composition. So that is homopolysaccharide. Homo means the same unit will be involved in the composition of that particular polysaccharide. Same, the single type of, only one type of मोनोमेरिक यूनिट. द हेटरोपॉलीसेकेराइड विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू 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 और मोर देन टू टाइप्स ऑफ मोनोमेरिक यूनिट. एंड द बेस्ट एग्जाम्पल इज वी कैन से द पेप्टिडोग्लाइकेन. लाइक पेप्टिडोग्लाइकेन इज द पॉलीमर ऑफ नैग एंड नैम, एन एसिटाइल म्यूरमिक एसिड एंड एन एसिटाइल ग्लूकोसामाइन. सो देर आर टू शुगर, टू टाइप्स ऑफ शुगर्स इन्वॉल्व. सो दैट्स वाई इट इज हेटेरो पॉलीसेकेराइड, राइट? सो होमो एंड हेटेरो, दो दीज पॉलीसेकेराइड्स कैन बी क्लासिफाइड एज होमो एंड हेटेरो. आफ्टर दैट वी विल लुक सम एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ पॉलीसेकेराइड. लाइक फर्स्ट वन इज द स्टार्च. सो वी नो स्टार्च इज द स्टोरेज फॉर्म ऑफ पॉलीसेकेराइड. इट इन्वॉल्व इन द एनर्जी स्टोरेज, राइट? स्टोरेज, नॉट इन्वॉल्व इन द स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स बट स्टोरेज इन प्लांट्स. स्टार्च इज द पॉलीमर ऑफ डी ग्लूकोज यूनिट. वॉट? डी ग्लूकोज यूनिट्स. सो इट इज द होमो पॉलीसेकेराइड वी नो. सो ऑल द मोनोमेरिक यूनिट विल बी ऑफ डी ग्लूकोज. सो डी ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल्स विल जॉइन टूगेदर विद द हेल्प ऑफ, सपोज दिस इज वन डी ग्लूकोज, दिस इज सेकेंड, दिस इज थर्ड. सॉरी माई ड्रॉइंग इज नॉट वेरी गुड. दिस इज फोर्थ ग्लूकोज मॉलिक्यूल. ओके, सो दीज सो मेनी थाउजेंड्स ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स विल बी गेट जॉइंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ अल्फा वन फोर ग्लाइकोसाइडिक बॉन्ड. वॉट इज अल्फा वन फोर ग्लाइकोसाइडिक बॉन्ड? द फर्स्ट कार्बन ऑफ द शुगर. दिस इज द फर्स्ट कार्बन. हाउ वी नंबर द कार्बन ऑफ द शुगर? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 एंड दिस 6 हेक्सोज शुगर, राइट? सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट कार्बन ऑफ द शुगर, फर्स्ट शुगर, एंड दिस इज द 1, 2, 3, 4. दिस फोर्थ कार्बन ऑफ द सेकेंड शुगर विल गेट जॉइन. दैट्स वाई वी आर कॉलिंग इट एज अल्फा 1,4 ग्लाइकोसाइडिक बॉन्ड, विच इज इन्वॉल्व इन द जॉइनिंग ऑफ टू शुगर्स. सो इन द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्टार्च दीज मॉलिक्यूल्स विल बी जॉइंड बाय अल्फा 1,4 ग्लाइकोसाइडिक बॉन्ड. एंड also there is alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond. Alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond is present and it is involved in the branching of the starch. So starch is not a linear molecule. Starch is not a polymer, linear form of molecule, or we can say linear polysaccharide. Starch is the branched polysaccharide. So branched and linear. So it branches are involved. So branches will be there after 25 to 30 units of D glucose. After 25 to 30 units of D glucose, there will be branch of that polysaccharide, and it will be formed with the help of this alpha 1,6 glycosidic bond. And the in this way, this molecule will be joined. Why we are calling it as alpha 1,6? Because the sixth carbon will get formed of, will form a bond with this first carbon of the sugar, and this branch will be formed, and in this way this branch will be formed after 25 to 30 units of D glucose units, right? So this is the branched polymer. And this starch is starch consists of two types, we can say two molecules, like amylopectin and amylose. Let me see for my reference. Starch is consist of amylose and amylopectin. So what is amylopectin? Amylopectin is the these branches are involved in the amylopectin. So where there is branches, that is amylopectin. And linear polymer in which only 1,4 glycosidic bonds are present, that is amylose. So in starch we can see both the types of chains, branched as well as unlinear. So branched amylopectin, and involve 1,6 glycosidic linkage also, and the amylose, which involves only linear polymer, only involved the 1,4 glycosidic linkage. So this is all about starch. It is the homopolysaccharide, and what it functions, the storage molecule, it stores the energy, it stores the sugars in the form of starch in case of plants. So if the organism, or we can say if the animals are animals want to store their energy, so they do not store like their energy into the starch molecule, they have the glycogen. So in animal cells there is glycogen. Glycogen is very similar to starch, but it is only involved in the animal cells, and it is also the storage molecule. It is also stores the energy, or we can say they store the carbohydrates in the they also store the carbohydrate in the form of glycogen. So what is glycogen? Glycogen is also the polymer of D-glucose unit, and it is also highly branched polymer like starch, but the branches are after the 8 to 10 units of the glucose molecule. In case of starch, there are branches after the 25 units of the glucose, but here we can see the branches after the 8 to 10 units of the glucose molecule. So that is glycogen, and it is also performs a function like storage molecule in the case of animal cells. So this is glycogen, and very similar structure to the starch molecule, but only difference is that the starch the branches is after the 8 to 10 units of the sugar molecules like glucose molecules. After that, another example is cellulose is the most abundant organic compound in the biosphere, because cellulose is the structural polysaccharide. The polysaccharide we studied earlier, like starch and glycogens, are the storage polysaccharide. This is the structural polysaccharide involved in the structure of the cell wall of the plants, right? So this is the structural polysaccharide, and this is the linear one. Linear glycogen and starch are the branched polysaccharides, but this is the linear polysaccharide, do not involve any branches. Only 1,4 glycosidic bond will be present, and all the sugar units will be joined with the help of that 1,4 glycosidic linkage. That is cellulose, the structural polysaccharide we can found in the plants. So these are the homopolysaccharides. These are the examples of homopolysaccharide: starch, glycogen, cellulose, and chitin is also there. After that, the heteropolysaccharides are also there, like peptidoglycan molecule, which is involved in the cell wall synthesis of some bacteria. The structure of peptidoglycan is little complex. I will make another deep video in the structure and the function of the peptidoglycan, and the structure of peptidoglycan. In the next video we will study the structure of peptidoglycan in detail. So I hope it is helpful to you. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share this video to your friends. Thank you so much.